The American poet who radically experimented in his poems with form, punctuation, grammar, and spellings also invented compound words to create a highly individualistic style in 20th century was Edward S. Lynn Cummings. For a long time, Cummings was thought of as a classically influenced poet, but with time he came to be regarded as a towering figure of modernism, as he moved away from the traditional ways of writing. You can clearly identify the difference in his poems that look like this, this, and this, to poems looking like this and this. Born on 14th October 1894 in Cambridge, Massachusetts, he was deeply influenced by his father, Edward Cummings, who was a professor of sociology and political science in Harvard University. E.E. Cummings wrote poems as early as the age of 10, and his mother kept as many of them as she could. She also instilled in him a love for language and encouraged him to sketch and write verse. Because of which, Cummings wasn't just a poet, but also painted a lot. He received his B.A. degree in 1915 and was awarded an M.A. degree in 1916, both from Harvard University. Cummings was a great pacifist. He did not support the idea of war and violence. He was imprisoned for 3 months on suspicion of holding views critical of the French war efforts. And just before America entered World War I, he became an ambulance driver in France. He recounted his jail experiences in his autobiographical prose novel, The Enormous Room, 1922. He attained great popularity, especially among young readers, for the simplicity of his language, his playful mood, and his attention to the subjects such as war and sex. The love poems and religious poems represent Cummings' greatest achievements. Usually, the two subjects are interrelated in his work. For example, Somewhere I Have Never Traveled Gladly Beyond is one of the finest love lyrics in the English language. And Cummings' elegy on the death of his beloved father, My Father Moved Through Dooms of Love, is a profoundly moving tribute. His first book, Tulips and Chimneys, published in 1923, was followed by a second book of poems 2 years later. Though Cummings received the Dial Award for Poetry in 1925, he continued to have difficulty in finding a publisher. At the time of his death, on September 3, 1962, he was the second most widely read poet in the United States, after Robert Frost. I carry your heart with me, E.E. Cummings. I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. And whatever is done by only me is your doing, my darling. I fear no fate, for beautiful you are my world, my true. And it's you are whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing is you. Here is the deepest secret. Nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky of the sky, of a tree called life, which grows higher than soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart.